Okay, guys.
In the previous class, we had an introduction about the mechanical template. We have linked our architectural file, and we have started allocating our spaces in the model so we can get all the information there. Such like the way that we have done everything in the electrical template. Today, we are going to be introduced to the mechanical boards, so we can have our mechanical network in the building, the ducts, the fuses, the main objects in the ceiling, in the roof, the air terminals, the accessories, everything. And then we will be introduced to the duct sizing calculations and how to get the reports for the building about the mechanical objects. Fine. Let's start. We are going to start a new file. Since we are working on the mechanical template, we are going to browse and go to our mechanical template. This one. Open. Okay. Then we are going to what? Drag our link. Sorry, drag our architecture file into our mechanical by accessing the insert panel. Then the link pivot. And then we are going to browse so we can get to our file. Here, make sure that you are positioning the file for the origin to origin, so you will get the same coordinates. It will update your files if they are done in the previous versions. Then you will have your model inside your file. Select the link, make a bin option, so you can move it from the place you have allocated. Fine. They have mentioned all of that. Sorry, we want that screen. Okay. Now you know that you have to make your spaces. I will not talk about spaces right now because we have done that. Today we are going to start our mechanical equipment allocation in our file. As you know, you are starting from the big objects to the small object to the smaller one. Like you are putting your rooftop objects or units, then your BAPs to distribute your ducts, and then your air terminals and GTM ducts in your spaces. Point. If you have to do or to put or to insert any of the ducts accessories or mechanical accessories, you have that option in the bit also, so you can do everything in this program. And then you can check your objects in the 3D view, so you can know if there is any flashes, you can deal with that, these flashes by moving your objects up or down or making any design decision. Let's go.
Worksets?
What?
Worksets.
I'm not talking about worksets. Please, guys, I will answer all the questions in the time. What's happening? How to make a worksheet?
Please, last, tell me, we can start with worksheet.
I didn't talk about this class. I will say it during the classes. Okay, guys, please, if you have any question about the currently things that you are talking about, do it. Feel free to ask. If I'm not mentioning the subject that you are going to ask about, and I told you that I will do that, please give it to the time. Okay? Okay, now we are going to our elevation, so we can add our depth. The main one that I need now, that I need the roof depth. So I will go to architecture, datum and level, then I will pick my level from here. And you know that you can do that by copying from the link file. So I will move it out, I will take this check, and I will rename this level to be the roof depth. Fine. Do you want to rename the corresponding views? Yes, I want to do that. Okay, now I want to go to view. Oh, without going to view, I will go to my project browser and will pick my roof level. See, that's there. And then the third one. Fine. Double click on the roof. Now I have it here. I have just told you that you are going to start from the rooftop objects, which is air handling units, and then go to your other objects, so you can go systems, and under mechanical you will have mechanical equipment. just click on mechanical components. So you have the family loaded into your file like AHU and blah blah blah. You can select from it. If you don't have your object or your family loaded here, you need to load it or insert it from your computer, right? So I will go to load family and I will go to the place where I store my family. So for me, now I put some families on my desktop. I will go to the desktop and now I have the outdoor air handling gear. I will click on this and will click on open. Now I have to place it on the required or desired place. Then move it as you wish. If you select this object or the air handling unit, you will find some points where you can add your ends and outs. Either if they are ducts, piping, or whatsoever you need, you have these points where you can connect all the needed equipment or all the needed fixtures. Fine. You have some properties for this unit, so you can edit or adjust them as you wish. For me, I want to make it above the roof by 50 centimeters, so it can be embedded or it could be protected. I will make it 5 millimeters or 50 millimeters. I will make sure that my units are millimeters. Fine, if they are millimeters, so I will go on. If not, I will edit my units so from inches or instead of inches, I will select it. Select your panel or your air handling unit. If you scroll down, you have leather, so it's allocated on the rooftop. You have offset, so it's still 50 millimeters above your leather. If you go down, you can read all the options and you can adjust all these numbers to meet your design criteria. Fine. That's about the air handling units and everything will work in the same procedure. If you are going to add, for example, PAD, are going to go to mechanical equipment and load your family if you don't have it in the template and then allocate it in your building. But I want to make sure that we are marking our objects correctly. Like if I'm using air handling unit, I want this name to appear in the tagging stage. So I will click here AHU-01 for example. So now I have marked my unit AHU. That's better now.
No.
But now you have to look for your rules. That's what I was trying to feed. Fine. Okay guys, now I have allocated my AHU unit. To check it in section if it's the best allocation for it, so I will go to my section mark from here. Just allocate your section and then double click on this icon so you will have it in your section and it's above the level. The same distance that you want to select it, you have all these connecting points. Fine. Let's go to our ceiling plan. I will go to level 1 ceiling plan. Or level 2 or whatsoever. Sorry. Fine. So here, ceiling plans, level 1. In our ceiling plans, what we are adding is, I have just mentioned, the VABs and the air terminals, ducts, or the things that I need. So I will go to my mechanical equipment again. I'm gonna browse my types and the VABs. I will find many. If you don't have, just go to your family. Select one of your families and then go to the place that you are allocating your VABs. Let's say that we need to add one here, for example. Let's say I will here. This message is saying that it's not visible in your plan because of the view ranges that you are cutting on the level, for example, and you are not seeing good points. Okay, let's go for the section again, just to make sure where our model is. If I don't have it, I will allocate it here. This is our object. Fine. I will click WT for Windows Dialing. Sorry, but because the screen is small, we can't see everything. WT again. We have this thing. come here. Let's try. Now I have cached my event. I will make the level like, let's make an alignment, for example, this way, align to the ceiling, and then move it up, and it like minus 6. Why? Let's go to the plan. Now we want to make some adjustments on the view range so we can catch all of this. It's the ceiling plan. I will select nothing, then I will go down in the numerical palette till I get to view range. Click on edit. Now you have these options. The cut plane is 200-300. Maybe it should be lower or higher. I have to know what is the level of the BAB, then I can know what's the number to be here. But let's close this, go here, and we have an annotate spot elevation. In the section, you can spot this elevation. It's a 300-183. Let's just edit our view range. Go down, and the view range, let's make it like 300-200, for example. Apply, and okay. I'll then get it here. I will re-edit my, let's make it unlimited, make it unlimited, apply, and okay.
Unlimited, so what's the unlimited
this? Unlimited, if it's for the view depth, so it's seeing all the way down.
All the way down?
Yes, if it's for the top, the plane is seeing all the way up. Now, if you have the view range option here, you have a cut plane on, like, for example, 1.2 meters. So you are cutting the building in the plan on 1.2 meters and looking down. If you are looking for the view depth and make the level unlimited, so it's starting from the 1.2 and seeing all the way down.
If a 1.2 isn't down, maybe isn't ground.
The floor plan is always looking down.
Yeah,
the ceiling plan always looking up.
It's unlimited, right? Then unlimited. So it will be taken from bottom,
the
ground floor, right?
Yes.
Footing. So the 1.2 is in the ground floor, right?
No.
Not
it's
like.
According to your levels. If you are in the ground floor, the height of this ground floor is like 4 meters, for example. If you are cutting on 1.2, so you are cutting here, right? If you have the view depth for this level only, you are seeing this time only. If it's for the associated, the level below, so you are looking on the ground floor since we are in the mezzanine floor. Right? Let me answer. I will say everything. Now, if you are making it unlimited, it will look to the B1, B2, blah, 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 all the way down. Fine? It's about the cut plane and the view depth. If you are looking for the top option, I'm cutting here. When you have a top option, so you are seeing this hidden, for example, you are seeing this hidden and going up, 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 till you get the level you are associating here. If it's unlimited, so it's all the way up to the highest point of your project.
If the layer is not off, we can use low all. Right?
Yes, so you can see everything. If the layer, we don't have layers, if the objects are sharp.
Yeah, it's your reference.
Yes. I will not pay attention a lot for this object, maybe it's another level. Let's go here. That's my behavior. Fine. So you have many options that makes the object is not appearing. The first one that we were in a wrong level because it's named wrong. It's one ceiling mesh or mechanical, sorry. So I thought it's the level one. We were looking for an object in another view. Zero was the level one. Okay? So the first option that you are in the wrong view. The second option that your objects are hidden, simply that someone right click and hide and make it hidden. Fine? If you are showing it again, we set it in the next class, click on this small button, it will reveal your hidden objects, select one of your objects, and then on reveal, choose and hide it. Fine? That's the second option. The third object, and we have mentioned in the last next class also, if you go to VG, you will have some objects are opt in this menu. If you want to show them, just click on the small text here. Fine. And the fourth or fifth option, that your objects are temporarily hide. Like I click on this sunglasses and click on hide elements, for example. You will have this blue report. Just click on the same option and reset the temporary isolate or hide options. Fine. These are some of the options that make your object hidden. Okay, now we have our BMD here. We will select the object, and we will make it VAB-01 in the map. Fine. So when I tag this BMD, I will get VAB-01. If I am copying this VAB to another place where I can have another one here, for example, if I am creating more than one zone, if I select this VAB, I will have the mark counting automatically. But if I have a third one, it will be VAB3 and so on. If you select one of your VABs, you will find that you can make in and out ducts for the supply ducts and for the retail. Fine. Then you are going to place your air diffusers in your doors so you can collect everything. I will go to the room or the required room, for example here. I will enlarge the screen and I will go to systems. If you are creating some air diffusers, you will click on air tab. Then you are going to load your family, or if you have it here, you can select from here. Now I have it here, supply diffuser, and this is the family that I'm using. I will click on it and come. I will come to this level and click, but I have the same message that none of the created objects are visible in this view. I will go to the section of the 3D. Before going there, I will go to annotate, spot elevation, and spot this elevation so I can know what's the number or what's the height. So it's 2, 4, 3. Let's go to the 3D again. I will select my user. I will make the level 2, 4, 3, 8 to meet the same level of the same. Fine. Let's go back to our RAM. We have it. Some of the tracking guides prefer to keep these arrows so we can know the orientation or direction of the air. But for me, I don't prefer them. If you are going to move these arrows here, you can come select the air terminal and just uncheck these options, which is about the apps. Fine, if you want them to remain in your drawing, just check them on. I will now align so I can obtain the same orientation of the ceiling tiles. I will click on align for this axis, sorry. I will click on the axis, and then for this one, I will click on the axis. Then I will move these objects from this place to the required MV for move. Then move from here to there, then move from here to there. Fine. If you see, it's the same process of adding any object on the left. I will now copy, maybe from here, take from here to there, and I will move. Fine. Maybe I need more than these, so I will copy them. I will make one here. And I will rotate RO for rotation, space for placing the rotation point. I will click here, then I will click on the required axis, and then I will rotate my map. I will copy it from here to there. Fine. I will copy these two to my map. So it's the way of adding some air turbulence in your space. Any questions? Is it difficult or easy? Do you think it's easy or difficult to add some equipment to your mechanical printer? It's easy, right? Okay, let's add some spaces again so we can remind ourselves about how to add spaces. We will go to analyze. We have a space option. We will click on it. Can I add a space now? I can't add a space. Since it's red or pink as you see, so I can't add a space. Why? Because my pink model is not a room bounding one. Just make sure that you are turning on this option, then click on apply and then OK. You will add your spaces now easily. So go to analyze again, space, click here, you can add the space, click here, here, blah 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 blah. But now we will be introduced a new option that you can place all the spaces automatically. Click here, it will automatically add all the spaces for you. Fine. Just click on this family for the tags. If you remember, we will edit the family. We click on space name and edit label. What should I do now?
Ability.
What?
Selecting date.
Yes, and then?
My room name.
I am reading the room name. Perfect. Okay. I will select this number, then search. I will edit the label. Yes, we are reading the room number. So we can have the same room, the same space and space number and space name, same as the room and the number and name in the architecture. Just click on number, okay. Now we have it loaded and our project override the existing version. Now we have all them. Why it's unoccupied?
The architectural fit came in not
what?
Architectural, that is not available.
Yes, in the architecture module we don't have a room here. Maybe because it's shaft. Fine? So we will go to create. We are going to create a schedule for the spaces. Then we can compare. If we don't have the room here, we can move it. Fine? So let's go to the schedules. We did all that in the electrical model, in the schedule. We will create spaces here, right? I'm going to click OK. In the fields, in the spaces, we are going to read the space name and space what? Number. So click on N for name and number, click OK. Change it to rooms. Room what and what? Name and number and add them, click OK. Now you have all the schedule. Fine. I will click on sorting and grouping to organize these fields. I will organize them by name first or by room name. You can select whatever you want and click OK. You have these spaces here without room naming. You can select them all and then delete. Do you want to delete these objects? Yes. So they are all deleted. You have here the spaces, change them to match these names in the list. Fine. That's all what we have to do once we start our mechanical project on mechanical. Please open your systems, open a new file, name the architecture, and do the same that we have done now.